वेलकम टू ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम ऑफ मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल स्कूल हिसवा। अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आसिफ, मैथमेटिक्स टीचर। ओके, एंड आई एम बिफोर यू बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एंड सोल्व क्वेश्चंस ऑफ चैप्टर 7, मल्टीप्लिकेशन एंड डिवीजन ऑफ फ्रैक्शंस। Okay, so friends, this chapter is based on the previous that you have learned in the previous class. This is the revision tabs. Now have a look. As you can see, book is 7th chapter, multiplication and division of fractions. Now first the revision, this is the exercise 14. Okay, now we are going to solve a couple of questions from this. Okay, so get ready to learn. Let's take started. So exercise 14. Now see friends, we have taken question number 1 of sub questions D. Okay, now here first question says fill in the blanks with the proper fractions. Okay, here the sub questions D, 15 and 1/3 dash. Now if you remember, then you come to know, we have to multiply this 15 multiplied by 3 plus 1 divided by 3 as it is. Here now 15 multiplied by 3 plus 1 divided by 3. Now solve. 15 multiplied by 3, this is 45 plus 1 and divided by 3, this is equal to 46 by 3, because 51 plus 1 46, so we have to fill here 46 by 3. I hope you can solve A, B and C. Okay, now and friends, one thing is here, fill in the blanks with the improper fractions. Always have a look, the mixed fraction will always turn as a improper fraction. And what do you mean by improper fraction? Fractions having numerator greater than denominator. Here the numerator 46, this is greater than this denominator, so this is called the improper fraction. Now see friends, question number second, fill in the blanks with mixed fraction. So now the first question was is the mixed fraction, and we have already turned into the improper fraction. So this question number 2 is just vice versa of question number 1. So have a look, question number 2. Now we have taken any sum of the questions. So question D, here 97 divided by 12. And now the question once again says fill in the blanks with mixed numbers. Now first of all divide this number, divide 97 by 12. Here 97 divided by 12, 12 1 12 8 96, this is 1. Okay, now this can be written as, now denominator as it is. Now here the remainder is as up. Okay, now this is quotient is here. Okay, this is your answer. I hope you will understand. So friends, these are the very simple questions, revision types of questions. Here question number 3 says write the fraction in their lowest term. What about the lowest term? Means there are 4 questions, sub questions A, B and C, C and D. First of all, we have to find the HCF of numerator and denominator of every fraction. Suppose the HCF is other than 1, then we have to divide numerator as well as denominator by the HCF. As have a look, here third number, write the fractions in their lowest terms. Suppose question number D, I have taken question number D, 36 divided by 63. Okay, now the HCF is, suppose the HCF 36 can be written as 2 multiply by 3. Once again 2 multiply by 3. 2 3 ja 6, 2 3 ja 6, 6 6 ja 36. Now 63 can be written as 3 multiply by 3 multiply by 7. 3 3 ja 9, 9 7 ja 63. Now here is the common term, because the SCF, here is the common, once again here is the common. Okay, have a look. That means the SCF is 3 3 single 3 multiply by this is 3. Now we have to take in away the common values of 36 and 63. Here is the common, one time 3 is common, once again the second time 3 is common. That means here is the 9, so the LCM is 9. Now we have to divide this numerator by HCF 9, and denominator also divided by 9. So 9 4 ja yes 36, and 9 7 ja yes, this is 4 by 7. 4 by 7 is your final answer. I hope you can solve A, B and C. Now friends, question number 4, have a look. For write each of the following as fraction. Fraction means A upon B form, means numerator and denominator form. Okay, now for we have taken question number, suppose D. Here 1 divided by 15 is equal to dash. Now this is simple, this is 1, because the first number, the first term should be as, should be in numerator, and second last one is denominator, because 1 divided by 15 is equal to 1 is up and this is 15 is downward. This is your answer, and this is as fraction form. Here is the numerator and this is the denominator. So the numbers which is A by B form, where A, B are natural number, here A and B, and these two numbers are natural numbers, so this is called the fraction. Okay, now see friends, question number 5 number says fill in the blanks, and we have taken one sub questions of question number 5A, 14 by 33 minus 8 by 33, and we have to fill here. Okay, now first we have to solve. Okay, now first write, now solution is, here is the denominator, look at all denominator, because the denominator are same. Now we have to draw the line or the parts of line and write the single denominator in the position of same denominator, and now write your numerators as it is. Here is the 14, here is the 14, here is the minus, here is the minus, and this is 8, 8. Why? Because we have all denominators are same. So first of all draw the line or the part of line, then write the single denominator at the same position as denominator, then write down all numerators as it is. Okay, now subtract 14 minus 6, 8 is equal to 6 divided by 33. Now this is 3 2 ja 3 1 ja 3 1 ja, that means 2 by 11 is your answer. Okay, 2 by 11, I hope you will get. Now next friend, question number 6, add, because 6 number has A B C D E and F questions. Okay, now we have taken one sub question as T. So here 4 1 by 2 plus 3 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4, this is, these two are the mixed fraction, and this is another is the proper fraction. Now first we have to turn this two mixed fraction into improper, as now solution is 4 2 ja 8, 8 plus 1 9. Okay, this is 9 by 2. Now this is plus, here is plus, here plus, 3 2 ja 6 plus 1 7, 7 by 2. Here is plus, this is 1 up by 4. Okay, now see, now take the LCM of 2, 2 and 4. Here if the LCM of 2, 2, 4, here have a look, 2, 2, 4, the LCM is obviously 4, yes, sorry, 2, 2 1 ja, 2 1 ja and 2, 2 2 ja 4, so 4 is the LCM. Okay, now see what we are going to do. First we have to divide this LCM by this one. Now we have to solve for this individually. Now first we have to see this number 9 by 2. Now divide 4 by 2 becomes 2. 2 multiply by 9. 9 to 18. Here is plus plus. Once again, this 4 is divided by 2. 2. 2 multiply by 7. 14. Okay. Plus. Now this 4 is divided by this. This 4 is divided by this 4. 1. 1 multiply by 1. 1. Now this is 33. Okay. 33 by 4. Here 4, 5, plus 8, 13, 13, 1, 1 is 3, 1 is balance, 1, 2, 3. Okay, this is your answer. I hope you will understand. So friends, you can easily solve all the questions. Your homework is 1 to 8. Your homework is 1 to 8. Okay, question number 1 to 8. Revision exercise 14. Now friends, see, question number 7 is same as question number 6. In question number 6 we have to add, in question number 7 we have to subtract. Okay, now 8 question, consider the fractions this and this. Now fill in the blanks. We have to find the greatest fraction among these given fractions, and we have to find the smallest fraction among these fractions. And this question, okay, we have to solve all the questions. Okay, if you have any doubt or queries, please contact me, ask me. Okay, have a nice day.